I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
How many people have been here before on this track? Or how many are first time on this track? First time drivers on the track. Okay. Great. We have Cali Photography's here shooting photos today. They're in the truck against the fence that way. They shoot photos in the morning, they put them up in the monitor in the afternoon. If you definitely want photos, you should book with them ahead of time. That they focus on you throughout the day, you get shots of your car. So if you want photos, go see them once the meeting's done and set up with that. Okay. We'll have food trucks here probably pretty, I don't know, 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, they'll start showing up. I recommend going and having your lunch at like 10 a.m. If you go get in line at noon, you might have your lunch by 3 p.m. Okay? So your choice, it's just my recommendation. A lot of good food, but long lines and all that. Can't have it. Okay. The gasoline is sold, pumps are on the far side of that garage building, right over there. And they're sold at the top of the hour, on the hour, every hour. So 8, 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, et cetera, up until I think 5 o'clock is the last one. If you show up at 5:15 or 5:20, they'll be locked. You'll have to come back to the next hour mark. But if you come back at 10:15, you have to come back at 11. So just try to get there at those times, please. It's cash only at the pumps. You cannot pump 98 or 110 fuel into non-race prep vehicles. So it's just one of the rules here at the track. If you show up with gas jugs, they have to be labeled for competition use only. And then you can
go with gas jugs. Can we go off-site? Gas?
You can. I just don't know how the re-entry process would be. I don't know how take an hour.
It's fine.
Yeah. Yeah. It could be risky. Okay.
No, you don't.
If you're doing a different challenge today, please fill out a competition form before you go on the track so you know what class you fit into. We appreciate that. Restrooms are at the end of this building over here. The schedules and track maps that you guys should all have, it's good to have those out for the meeting because the track map has stuff on it that I'm going to cover. Okay, if you guys, anybody here wants to switch run groups for some reason, if you're too slow for you, too fast for you, just come see us and we'll do our best to move you around, okay? Coming back tomorrow, you need to get a new wristband for the second day. Coming back to the driver list tomorrow. All students, everybody who has signed up for instruction today, if you brought your own instructor, you're fine. But if you are using one of our instructors, you want to be at registration 20 minutes before your first session. So 20 minutes early so we can introduce you to your instructor. Okay, so please be on time. Most difficult part about instruction is finding your instructor. The hardest part. So please get there early so we can get introduced. If you are running a transponder on your car today, your times will be possibly up on Race Hero. If not, they will be printed at some point for the wall. There may be some delay before we get them out today, but eventually we will get those times out, get them posted up on the wall, or get them online. Please turn your transponder in before you go home today. They are $450 if you melt it on your exhaust pipe or you lose it, okay, or whatever else. So please take good care of them. And again, make sure you turn those in before you go home today. Okay, track entry at Auto Club Speedway is very difficult. Those of you who are first time ever driving on a track, you want to pay obviously very close attention. Everybody who has not been here before, pay extra close attention. If you get the entry wrong, you'll get black flagged and you'll miss half your session. Okay, so it's very important to get it right. It's a safety issue as well. That's the main reason to do it. So I will draw it for you guys on your map after the meeting if you don't quite understand what I'm about to tell you. So the first thing about getting on track is just going to go through the chain of events opening right over here, outside this garage here. This building. Go through the tunnel. The tunnel just goes right through the suites there. Go through that tunnel, you're going to make your first left hard left in the service pits. The second left is the hot pit. Don't go in the hot pit. So in the service pit, and that's our pre-good area where we line you up throughout the day. Now, when they release you, you're going to be sent out towards the painting of turn one and two. And the key thing is you don't drive onto the track. Do not drive onto it. You go up to it, but not onto it. So you're going to go up to it. You're going to stay on the flat spot at the base of the track, and that's it. The track itself is banked. There's a white line that separates the track that's banked from the flat spot. The flat spot is called the apron. You're going to stay on that apron all the way around turn one, turn two. Now you're going to head down the back straightaway. The white line that's on your right, if you're staying to the left of, is going to go hash marked. Still do not blend. Some groups say that that's called the blend line. So if you were running an oval track, like a NASCAR or IndyCar configuration, that's where you blend into track. You see that on television. But we don't blend. We stay to the left of that dotted line, even when it goes dotted. And we stay to the left of turn three as well. Hard left around turn three. So after turn three, you are still all the way on the left side of the track. Turn four, you can turn in for the apex of turn four if there's not a car there. Now, we're doing it this way so that in case there's somebody on track already, you guys can merge together and there's room for both of you. If you don't do it, you could be interfering with a car doing 130 miles an hour. Okay? So it's very important. Stay all the way left around the entire entrance, all the way around turn three, you're still left. Turn four, you're still left until you can turn in for four with, assuming you check your mirrors, make sure there's not a car. Okay. So again, I'll draw that for you if you need to after the meeting. The track exit is going to be turn 21 into the hot pit. We are not using the turn 9 exit. Those of you who have driven with us before, turn 9 is closed. It's just turn 21 hot pit for all track exits. Okay. Before you exit turn 21, position your car left, on the left side of the track for that last two turns. Fist out the window, warning people. Once you do that, people have permission to pass you on the right. Okay, so if you are on the right side of the track, which side you want to exit, you can't. You've got to go all the way around again. You can't shoot from the right side of the track across the track. So be left, fist out the window. Turn 21, you're going to be in the hot pit. The hot pit is big. The speed in the hot pit is 50 miles an hour, max speed. And your entrance back into the paddock is up that side of the paddock by the gas pump. So the very first left you come to, you'll go through that tunnel to get back in the paddock. This tunnel here is one way this way, that tunnel is one way that way. If you get a black flag today, you'll stay in the hot pit and drive all the way through the hot pit to the end, pull up on the left side of that hot pit wall, and stop and wait for the marshal to come by. And then, of course, you get released back on the track. When you get re-released back on the track, you are obviously going to re-enter the same way you did the first time. You're not going to go shooting on the track. Okay. So black flag station, once again, end of the hot pit wall for all black flags. Please don't come to registration and ask us why you got black flagged. We will not know why. Just go talk to the black flag person. Okay. Warm-up laps, folks, we want them to be quick. So let's just say, other than the first lap, first session today, and other than the blue group drivers, but everybody else, when you leave the hot pits for your second session, your third session, your fourth session, we need you guys to leave and drive quickly so that you gradually increase your speed so you can warm up your car. And so the people behind you can get warmed up. So don't leave the hot pits and just meander around, leaving at 20 miles an hour, okay? Put tires scrubbing like this. Just go out and drive quickly, pick up speed gradually as your car warms up so that that first lap, somebody else behind you can get the car warmed up. Cool down laps are also a reasonably quick pace after the checkered flag. We want you to maintain about 70% of your normal pace after your checkered flag. So a pretty good quick cool down lap as well, please. Okay, passing rules for black and purple. Point by passing everywhere on track. Open passing on the front straight. So let's start with the point by. So if you want some, and blue group drivers, you'll be doing point bys either right away or later depending. So you want to pay attention to how the point bys are done. So the passing in these groups, you guys, is all with point by. Basically, if you see somebody in your mirrors, that means they're quicker than you. you want to point the bike. So you want to pass it on the left side, you point to your left. You want to pass to the right side, hand out as far as you can. So don't just go like that. That's pointing at the bird. And don't wave like this. Don't do this. This is an emergency hand signal for when there's a problem. Okay, it's pass to my left, pass to my right. It's 1 point per car, so if the car's in front of you got point fives, and everyone's passing somebody, you don't get to pass unless you also clearly got a point five. Okay. If you're doing the pointing, and you see five cars behind you, let's say, and you're given straightaway, just keep your hand out. Just keep pointing every one of them. And of course, before you go turn into the corner, check your mirrors, make sure there's not a car finishing the last pass. Okay. When you point people by, obviously, you want to make sure there's room to pass you. Don't point them by in the dirt. Don't point this way and then turn that way. Stay consistent and point them on this side or that side. We want you to do your point bys. We want you to hold the driving line when you're on the straightaway. So if you're pointing in the straightaway, you want to be on the proper line, set up for that next upcoming corner. So if the next turn is a left turn, you're going to be on the right side of the track. You're going to be far right. You point these people by, they got to go offline around you back online. So don't move your car out of the way offline. Try to point and then try to get back online. Just stay online and then go offline around you. And that again has to setting up for the next corner. Okay? Now, if you're going to point somebody by in a turn, which you can do in the black group and the purple group, you stay on the outside of the corner and give the overtaking car the inside of the corner. So don't point people around the outside. You stay wide. Point them on the inside, and you slot it behind. Okay. It's really important that you guys do a lot of point bikes, especially session one. Session one, half the people have been here before, half the people have not been here before. Lots of people warm up quickly, some people warm up, take a couple sessions to warm up. So it's important that you guys do a lot of point bikes, you're very generous with those. It's a straight up courtesy thing. Don't point someone by and they're stuck behind you. They're not having fun at all. They're just bored, waiting to get by you. So lots of point bys, please. If you have a high horsepower car and you see you have a Mazda Miata behind you, that's not turbocharged. Regular Miata, for example. They might be quicker than your lap times. They may turn to be have a 1 second per lap quicker lap time because they're quicker on the corners in your car. If the straightaways, you motor down the straightaway, you check your mirrors, there's no one behind you. Get to the corners, they're stuck behind you. So if that happens, you need to point that car by and get underway. Okay, so precedence goes to the cars that are turning quicker lap times. That basically means if someone catches you anywhere on track at any point in time, that means they're quicker, you need to point them by. Okay? So
So I got a guy, my guy, he'll hook it up. Nobody beats this guy. So the guy I sent you is really good for convenience.
Yeah.
You know, because he'll go to you, you don't have to do anything. But if you want to, you know, go a little bit less expensive, then.
See that?
Oh, yeah.
So each tire is
aggressive.
Each tire is what, $400, $500?
Yep. $500 a tire.
That's not too bad because a regular car, that's what that might. If you have just any high end car.
Now listen, so it's it's about $2,000 for tires, right?
Well, how fast do you go through?
But they only last about 4 track days. So, like today, today's gonna cost him about $500 for his tire wear alone. Then it costs another $250 to get in. Then it's another $200 in gas.
I have an idea.
And plus brake, you know, it's
okay. Which tire company? Brake Masters. Sponsors.
Yes. That's right.
Just Tires. I think so.
We need a tire sponsor.
Tires. Jiffy Lube.
Anybody wants to.
Jiffy Lube don't do tires, yeah. Fool.
No, but they could. They're related. Well, how about
I have my car with all the stickers.
Yeah.
Dodge. Sure. I think sponsors. So. I think that's the next level.
All sponsors.
Yeah, corporate sponsor, whatever.
What is he?
Maybe put a little sticker on your little shorts. Dunlop on your shorts for the bias.
Google tires.
That's it. What are the tires? Casa tires? I buy my tires there. They brought up Mexico, used tires. You never heard of that? Casa de tires in North Hollywood, Van Nuys?
It actually looks like a castle.
Yeah, it looks like a castle.
Green
The tires are like 20 bucks. Doesn't. Alright, 25 bucks.
I'll see you guys in a bit. Here, hold this for me.
This guy came all decked out. He thinks he's a NASCAR driver. It's like people come in a boxing ring, they never box, they dress like they're about to fight for the world title.
They do actually. Driver's
lounge. How come Mikey's not here?
Thank you.
It looks like he's going to.
Show you Mike's car.
Look at this, they're all sponsored out. Is he part of the Beamer Fest?
He did the wrap recently because he didn't have that before. He wears a suit. Checks out. Seeds.
The metal bars.
Roll bars.
That's in case he flips?
He removed the back seat. You see that? There's no back seat on it no more.
Yeah, that's it. This is a toy for an adult.
He drives it, the thing like really too. He drives it to work and back and everything.
Oh, it's street legal?
Yeah. Oh, this is street legal.
Is that a stick or automatic?
They're automatics, but they got the paddle shifting, so he uses it with the paddles on this. He's got the little shifter on this.
So this was 80 before it was decked out, and then he probably invested just as much.
Robert Hernandez got his. I think he said 90. I'm not 100% sure, but I think he said 90 on it. But then he completely added all kinds of shit, but...
What kind of car is this?
It's a Nissan GTR.
I didn't know Nissan made sports cars like that.
No. He got his, like I said, I think he said 90, but I'm not sure. But, it doesn't look like much. It looks like a stock car. But everything it has under the hood, the brakes, it's just everything else is where he modified it.
Yeah.
So
you can't even tell.
At first glance, I mean, that one with the roll cage, the seat.
Right, yeah, yeah.
Might look like that's, you know, wow.
The tail
racer,
and then, yeah.
The little twin. But this one actually does better times than that one.
Don't judge a book by its cover.
I do better times than him. But they got more experience. The last time we were here, I did better times than him. I don't know about now.
Extra loud, extra sound.
Some they put a different exhaust, different pipes, different exhaust. Sometimes it helps with horsepower. Sometimes it's just sound.
Just for show. Like people should know they're in the building.
Yeah.
So, Mikey, when people see you drive,
first mm-hmm. group is them actually at 9, ready.
The advance.
So they'll be at 9. They'll be doing the first session.
Will you go places with your Viper? People obviously notice the car first.
Yeah.
Then they notice you. What's the most common response you get?
They look at the car first. Yeah.
They want to know who's in it, though.
They normally always look at the car. They admire the car. They don't know who's inside.
Is that when a cop pulled you over just because he saw the car?
He does have a tire sponsor. Salinas Tire and Wheels.
There you have. You see? They hooked it up. Salinas, California. The cop wanted to pull you up. Over once just so he could see the car, just to have a picture with it?
One time. Yesterday I got a ticket.
What happened?
Something else. I was even driving my car. I was driving my truck.
Nothing related. You couldn't get it.
When they park cars in the front, you're like, all right, it's cool. But
that's okay, but if they take it, because I've seen the movies where they take it for a joyride.
No, but like, I had a valet a couple weeks ago, and then the guy just parked in, like, here's a key. You know, I don't want to be responsible. Yeah.
Is the insurance crazy on it?
Not
too
as
bad?
As crazy as you would think. You
yeah. Know. No, that's good.
Yeah. Not that bad. Could be worse. What time you guys racing?
First session, my boys, they're different groups, like I said, different groups.
Right.
My boys, the first group is at 9. Right now at 9.
It's pretty early.
Yeah, they sit all day thing. So then I go in like at 9:30.
I'm in a different group.
They have more experience than I do. We run about the same times, but
different classes. Yeah, I know. I went out with the experience class before when I was like starting up tracking. It's like you feel so much pressure.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Sure. Yeah, I go on a different route. You get 20 minutes each session.
How many cars?
They got like 20 cars
per
session.
Per session?
Man, right now it's actually really packed today. So I think they got more. But they it's a different track, so they can do it.
Cars still a lot, though.
They all in the same kind of group, so it's not like you're passing all these cars, you know,
right.
Kind of behind each other, almost parading. They're all running about the same time.
Can you pass on anywhere?
On their class, yes.
Anywhere?
Anywhere on track. I'm only on the straightaway.
Straight. I like that better.
It's safer for me.
Do you own this company?
No.
Okay, I see you. It's a license plate.
No, this just
happened. A coincidence?
Yeah. Well, it's going in their booth, but.
Got it. What did they build?
Exhaust system. Yeah. That guy runs it right there.
There's everything you could get here. Everything. Keychains to everything.
Probably build your whole car from just being around here.
Probably could.
Mikey, you and Jeff Gordon in a racetrack, then you and Jeff Gordon in a boxing ring. Who would do better? You think you would do better in a racetrack than he would do in the ring?
I think so. He beats me still at the track, but I still do better.
But you
better.
Don't get knocked out.
I still do better than what he does in the ring.
Yeah.
So he sent me his book, like by the way. He sent me a copy of his book.
Really?
Yeah.
He's badass. Nice guy. He's a big name.
Yeah, that was pretty cool.
Did you read it?
Yeah.
Jeff Gordon.
Jeff Gordon, my life. My something about his life, racing or something like that.
I think Ludacris mentioned him in a song,
see if I
right?
Got over here.
Some rapper put him in a song.
Sure.
I don't have a transponder, so I don't need that.
Do you ever see any celebrities here, Mikey, when you come?
I haven't seen them. They might be celebrities. They might be, you know.
Just casual, like, you wouldn't
tell? Yeah, I don't know.
So all these people are competing today. They're all going to race. Sorry. Did the Crawford call you out recently?
I don't know.
He said after Horn he wants to fight you.
Did he?
I think so.
Oh.
Yeah.
A little bit. You too? I thought she might be the race.
You got fans everywhere, Mikey. But you say the room is never this filled.
No.
Maybe they knew we were filming today, so they came to be on camera.
Dude, seriously, it's never been this bad. Like, normally it's, you know, it's in here. But today it's
got people standing outside.
Really packed. You need to get a Team Mikey Garcia outfit like that guy right there. Yeah?
Have you seen their shoes?
They're like boxing shoes.
Just turn They are like boxing shoes.
That way it's they're not thick for the pedals. Like mine are really, really thick. But they use
like I would go with the instructor for you. Some of their instructors.
So we don't overnap.
More control?
Yeah, it's easier to shift and hit the gas and brake without overlapping.
So you should have brought your boxing shoes.
I should have brought my boxing shoes.
You could have brought your headgear instead of a helmet. No, one time I asked Kobe, why does he use a motorcycle? Kobe Bryant loves motorcycle. He goes, because in my car, they recognize me and they're stupid. So I said, why don't you wear your helmet inside your car? He said, shut up, you're an idiot.
But, you can't do that.
No. But yeah, he would use motorcycles a lot, and people wouldn't know it's him. Yeah, exactly. They would never guess. Yep.
Never guess.
But it's dangerous in Southern California.
Very.
I really thought that I would come here to the track today, meet you at the gate, walk on, record you, and that's it. I didn't realize there's security, safety, registration. You have a lot of patience, dude.
And I have, like, even though I won't get on the track till another hour from now. Yeah, like in an hour I'll get on the track. But you still have to get here early to do the whole process, you know, the registration, the rules meetings, all that.
No, they take it very seriously. It's, you know, it's a dangerous sport. Who gives the lessons, you know?
The guy who signed us up, Eric.
Oh, okay.
And another dude.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach.